I thank Professor Zera, Mr. Borkut, and others who have made it possible for me to come here and talk to you today. I am neither a computer professional nor a professional musician, but my qualification is that I have been listening to music with attention for the past 65 years, something like that, and playing on the veena for about 55 years. The topic is how to generate synthetic music from the notation for Carnatic music. Basically, it's a very simple thing to generate synthetic music because, you know, if you know the frequency of the note, you know the shape of the envelope and the characteristics of the instrument. It's a very simple, straightforward calculation to produce it. But unfortunately, it doesn't work for Carnatic music. And the reasons for that, the traditional notation generally lacks any indication for up and down movements. About Gamakams yesterday, Mr. Krishna spoke elaborately. For instance, he said, "Ni, it is dasa dasa." Though you are saying ni, it's neither ni, neither ni, neither da nor sa. There's two more problems. Mostly notations don't have clear markings for silences. That's very important when you are trying to play a lyric on an instrument. Then there is no clear indication for grouping notes into phrases. These are generally presumed to be easily done by the musician himself. And historically, they have used this notation system only as something for purpose of memory. And the music was always transmitted orally. And even today, many musicians would rather learn it from another person than look at the notation and sing. But with the world becoming large and people living all over the world, there is a need to generate music from notation. So we have been, this Carnatic music is rich in compositions. In fact, the concert revolves around compositions. There is some extempore portion called Alapana, then the composition comes. There may be some more extempore area called Kalpana Swaram. But the main ingredient is the composition. And in spite of a lot of extemporization, you will find that two musicians who have not met before could almost sing them alike together. And the second thing about composition is that if somebody says whether this phrase comes yesterday, Krishna was saying, I said Rigama is not okay that way. No, I will show you some composition with that. And surprisingly, notations, printed books with notations came out as early as, I think the first book was 1869 in Telugu script. Then they keep on coming now. In the past 50 years, we have been having a lot of recordings. It is easy to record from any source, but still they are coming. It means that there is some need for this. So I thought that why not we do something to generate the true music. I had actually written a program which generates music from the notation. That's from Carnatic notation, sa, re, gamma, you type, and you choose the what we call melam scale, choose the tempo, you choose the tonic. It will play that, but it will play it just like that, straight. So Carnatic music notation is not graphic, it is solfa. The same sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, which is used for training in the early days of the student, is also used in the concerts as kalpana swaram. I am just giving this picture to show you the comparison. The graphic aspect doesn't exist there. It has been in your mind when you look at ga, look at ma, that notes frequency has to come into your mind. The next thing is that tonic is not fixed at all. Same thing as North Indian classical music. Mostly gents take C as the tonic, ladies take as G as the tonic, but there will be a lot of variations. I cannot sing at C because I am too old now. I go even below. But once you choose that that frequency for tonic, it is sa, whatever it may be, whether it's C or G, it is always sa. then we don't actually define flat and short notes. How the scale is built is based on what's called a Malam system, where a number is given. From the number you can work out what are the notes coming. And only when there's an accidental note coming, we put a star to show it's different. The last thing is that note duration is again highly personal. And this is the one which has given me a lot of trouble while synthesizing gamakams. Others were easy to manage. I'm giving here just a short piece, notation played without gamakam. Now this one. So there are two notes where the gamakama is put. Actually, when singing, we'll put on more notes also. But for simplicity, I have chosen two notes only. This is how the bare notation would be written. Actually, I've used the full consonant and vowel. Nowadays, in English notation, they are not using the vowel part of it. But when I write in Tamil, sa means one unit, sa means two units. So I've used the same thing. Now, if to hear the gamakams, you have to break it down like that. That ga was not simple ga. Di sa ri pa ga. That is actually ga ma. That is going up and down. The first line only. I will play it again because you can see the notation. This is the one which was straight. This is the one which got a gamagam, and here this also has a jaru, sort of a portmanteau. So I'm giving here some pitch graphs because gamagam is not a simple shaking of notes. That also is explained yesterday by Mr. Krishna. There are many problems come when you try to, even kampitam he was taking yesterday. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all of them are kampitams here, except the last one. But see the variety there. So this is the ragam called Maya Malava Gaula, which has a C and a D flat. The D flat part is played here. Now the same lady has played the same line again, but she had put a second, third shake there. So a lot of personal approach is possible. Now here, this is a violinist was asked to play it prolonged, that one. He's going up, at the end he's going to the next note. Now this one, the same. The difference is that here we are anchored on the lower note. More time was spent on sa and it went up and came down. Here it is hanging from down below from there. And this is the one he yesterday sang and showed you. So that ni is going from that to sa. This is the one which is extremely difficult to say where the note starts and where it ends. It's a ragam called Todi, it's very popular. I'm just saying a few words about my own program which generates music from notation. I believe it's the only program available for Carnatic music. The traditional notation puts a dot below the note for lower octave and a dot above the note for upper octave. And we generally don't go for more than three octaves. And it has borrowed the line from staff notation for doubling the speed. So I thought it's good to make it entirely workable on an ordinary text file. So I use both letters in same lower case is middle octave. First letter in lower case in lower middle octave. In lower case, and then next one is uppercase becomes lower octave. So like that I have tried to do that, and instead of these dashes lines I have put brackets. And I also provided a facility to check whether you close the bracket or not. Otherwise, everything will be played fast. Now, what are the problems in insertion of a gamakam? These are the problems not only for the computer, even for a musician. The gamakam for a note will vary from ragam to ragam. It will vary in the same ragam in different contexts. And it will vary from school to school. And as I said earlier, one case, neither the top end or bottom end of the pitch would coincide with the note. That's possible, that knee of Bhairavi. But there are so many advantages. This is a weakness, you can say, but it's an advantage that it gives freedom to the musician to interpret it and give some life to it. But still, he has some sort of a limits within which he can function. So how I have gone about doing this work of inserting gamakam notation? So the major parameters influencing gamakam are: what is the ragam? That's is understood. Duration of the note, as I showed earlier, that it was 700 milliseconds, it was 2 or 3 oscillations. When it became 4000, it was 7 or 8. So when somebody sings a note faster, he reduces the number of oscillations. He doesn't speed up each oscillation faster, and it actually look very ugly if you just take any composition and try to increase tempo and listen to it. The next is, what are the contexts? This also yesterday Krishna, same, he said sa re ga ga re sa. This re is different, coming down re is different. Again, he didn't talk about re re ga. So what he called jantaswara. Similarly, coming down. Then turning on the note. Gariga. Very often the gamaka will not be there. So the context is important. And sometimes the actual note following, so when you are going up, for instance, Kambodhi, Padasa and Padanida. Padasa, da will have extensive gamakam. Padanida, da will be stretched. So how I have gone about is that my program reads the notation and generates a context string which contains the information, whether it's going up or going down, turning at the note, etc. Then I have generated a gamakam definition file for each of the contexts and each durations. So actual duration could be anything because tempo is not fixed. So it's going to be very difficult to provide for every millisecond or so. I have grouped into 5 or 6 ranges, but the program allows you to change the ranges. Then when you run the program, it looks up that file and takes out the gamakam notation. Then it has to be shrunk or stretched to the actual duration of the note. Then only it will sound, otherwise rhythm will go off. So what we have found so far is that, yes, since I have written the program, I will say the results are good. But I've asked people to listen to it, and I found that for Varnam, the Varnam is a piece where it is composed with the notation in mind. And is usually taught just before the regular compositions, and many Vidwans sing Varnam as the first item in their concert. And the result for Kritis were acceptable in many cases, but the shrinking and expanding didn't work very well in all cases. I'm working on that. After listening to Sri Kumar, I may change the entire approach to it. These are the programs which I'm not showing here. Here there are again some examples of this part, first 4 lines. This is If I sing Bhairavi like that, I will be beaten. And this also, yeah. Actually, it's the first line of a song. There are other approaches possible. As I said, instead of giving the notation, you could prescribe parameters and the entire data could be generated in the background. I took this approach because in the beginning I could edit this, try again and again. And the parameters could be the duration of the note and what is the anchor point, above or below, and then what is the range of oscillation, and time up, time down, these are important. And we can even create generic notations, as Mr. Krishna was saying yesterday. The old ragas are very unique, you can't do anything with them. A lot of new ragas have come, I said they are synthetic ragas. You can produce a synthetic database using that idea. But my idea is that you should be able to produce from book notation by the books the sound. So still there are a lot of manual intervention. You have to type the notation. Then there is no phrase marking. There is no silence marking. All these things have to be done. And actually phrase separation I have attempted. And succeeded in marking the phrases automatically based on the lyric. And it works all right for fast melodies. For slower ones, I am finding it's difficult. Another problem is tempo has to be guessed. There's no indication anywhere. And even today, the same song, two different musicians will sing almost 1:2 tempo. Again, silences. There are two types of silences. One is when the long note is given, in the book it nothing, there will be no indication. You have to stop after some time and leave the rest silent. Other is when there's a consonant combination, like bhakta, that's a short breath, you stop the breath, bhakta, divya, like that. So that can be done easily. All these have to be done. So partly developed, partly under development. Here being an example of phrase, if phrase is not correctly marked, you're not able to recognize the lyric at all. Yesterday I gave this quiz to my son, who listens to lots and lots of Carnatic music. He couldn't find what it was. Now it's clear what the song was. Then there are other problems because there is time is limited. This is only further explanation of what manual things are required to be done. So this is sort of a flowchart which says what we should do. Starting from the book, get the music. Thank you.